Tonight, we will start the pagelaran or performance. And I want to ask Dr. Lisa Beardsley to come forward. And this is Arjuna, the character of Arjuna that will be played tonight. And I want to hand this to her so that she can give it to the dalang, the performer, Pastor Kurnaidi, and to ask him to start the performance.
Thank you for that background. I will read the scripture. You receive the text, 1 Peter 4:7. But the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. Invite the dalang to come forward, Pastor Kurnaidi, and we will be taken into a unique experience.
Thank you. earth is violently broken. The earth is split open. The earth is shaken exceedingly. The earth shall reel a to and fro like a drunkard, and shall totter like a hut. Its transgression shall be heavy upon it, and it will fall and not rise again. It is written in the story that there was a powerful warrior named Arjuna, a person who always did good to others and always obeyed his God command. But at that time, Arjuna was troubled. He was confused. He was frustrated, seeing and feeling what was happening in the lives of the people around him. With all the mighty and knowledge he has, Arjuna tries to solve the existing problem, but he cannot. Arjuna, you have chosen to live righteously. You always obey your God's command. Compare with me, Arjuna. Be realized. What have you gained in your life? Compare with me. Always pursues the profit. Even it is has to be done by cheating, it's not important for me, right or wrong, good or evil. The most important is now I am a king. I am a rich man. And look it. The woman you wonder of, now she is my wife. She always happy with me, Arjuna. Suddenly, Arjuna was roused by his anger. His man was stung when he remembered the cruelty of King Duryodhana and his brother. Arjuna immediately drew his weapon, will destroy King Duryodhana and the Kauravas. Be patient, my lord, be patient. And now, please sit down for a while, and please listen to what I have to say to you. Anjra ingkang puspita arum, kasilering samirono confused you are. when you see everything that is happening right now, wooden and annoyed and disappointed, if in reality the one who cheat is the one who always benefit. If the evil always win, it is evil and cunning people who actually live more prosperously than honest people. Hey, my lord, such attitude does not only occur in one place or in one country, but will occur throughout the world. Even in various aspects of life, including the religious aspect, nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines, and pestilence, and earthquakes in different place, and then shall many be often and shall betray one another, my lord, and one another shall hit one another, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. There will be more and more people who are smart at teaching the Holy Scripture, appearing as though they are saints or even angels of light, but in fact, they are just looking for money to fatten their stomach and enrich themselves. What they thought was not in accordance with what he did. Hypocrites like that will increase, my lord, in number and wander around looking for honorary positions. Therefore, the law is slack and judgment doth never go forth. For the wicked doth compass about the righteous. Therefore, wrong judgment proceeded. And that is what must happen, my lord. And all this chaos cannot be resolved by fighting. We should never really on our strength or intelligence. For truly our struggles is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against power, against the rulers of this dark world, against evil spirit in the air. Since everything will be destroyed in this way, what kind of people ought you to be? You ought to live holy and goodly life. What we can do is control yourself and be calm, my Lord, so you can pray. What must live at twofold life, life of doubt and action, of silent prayer and earnest works, prayer and effort, effort and prayer, will be the business of your life. You must pray as doubt the efficiency and praise were all due to God, and labor as thou duty were all your own. Commit your way to the Lord, trust in Him, and He will do this. Cast all your anxiety on Him, because He cares for you. Lenglenging priyo mangu-mangu, mangun kung kanduan rimang lireno tanpo kanin. Lireno tanpo kanin yen tan kuruso. Sang Piyakuto Thank you, Semar. Thank you. You give me the most important thing. So, come accompany me. I want to go so that I can be closer to the Creator. Gandane kang sekar gadung, lan kembang menut kang esmu arum. Winor lano kusumo mangambar-ambar mawur kuku sing tupoku malun kelun-kelun namur mego lir membo batoro tan samar pamoreng soksmo sinuksmo ya winahya ing sepi sinimpan telenging kalbu pambukaning warana tarlen sa liap layap pengang luyo. Raden Harjuna have gone with Lurah Semar Bodronoyo go to the top of the mountain of Indrokila.
Mm-hmm.
then Arjuna was already found the proper place to calm down his mind so that he can pray and become closer to the Creator. Leri, leri. In the middle of this Setu Puppet show, before we continue our Arjuna Wiyoho stories, please allow me, Ki Semar Bodronoyo, to greet the participants of the education conference held by the General Conference Education Department. First of all, we thank God who has blessed and protected us so that we can meet in this very special event. Then we thanks to Mrs. Lisa Bersley Hardy, PhD, MPH, and MBA, Director of Education Department for the Seventh-day Adventist Church General Conference. Please applause for her. Also, we thanks to Pastor Richard Sabuin, PhD, Associate Director of Education Department for the Seventh-day Adventist Church General Conference. Please applause to him. Because they were kindly to call the Setu Puppet team from Poncol Magetan Village, East Java Conference, so that I had the opportunity to support this special meeting. Likewise, thank you to committee, especially the Indonesian Adventist University, UNAI. Please applause also for UNAI, who serve us very well, so that this performance could be carried out. Ki Semar Bodronoyo also did not forget to thanks for all the educational conference participants who were special participants. Those are 107 Seventh-day Adventist University presidents, university board chairs, and campus spiritual life leader from the Southern and Northern Asia Pacific region. Maybe please also applause for all participants and all the attendants who I have not had a time to mention one by one. Hopefully, the simple things that I present can be useful and be a blessing for all of us in order to preach the everlasting gospel. As a sign of my respect, please, Sister Christina, to sing a song from Adventist hymnal to all participants in here. than Arjuna. Now has become a prior man, namely Begawan Ciptoning. Namely Begawan Ciptoning. No, now we will see Raden Arjuna in the mountain of Indrakila. Been several days since Arjuna had been calming down at the top of Indrakila mountain. Arjuna chose a cave called Mintorogo cave as a place to pray. That is why Arjuna was given the title Begawan Mintorogo, or known as Begawan Ciptoning. As for the name Ciptoning, it's a combination of two words. These are the word Cipto, which means mind, and the word Ning, which means calm, or clear, or holy. Sacrament of Earth is an absolute requirement for being a true human being. This can only be achieved if a human being is close to the Creator. It seems that Begawan Ciptoning's devotion to getting closer to his Creator was noticed by the Hapsara Hapsari in Suraloya. When Begawan Ciptoning, who was Arjuna, was diligently meditating, Prastas came to thwart him. Thank you. please accept me as your wife? Yeah, tobat, Arjuna. You are a handsome man. And I also happy if you allow me as your mistress, Arjuna. Please allow me. Many beautiful women come to tempt Arjuna, but Arjuna became more persistent in praying. Then help come from God in the form of a storm wind to sweep out this temptation. After that, a very powerful old man also came to test Arjuna. It's right, Panembahan. I am a warrior. And I am now in here because I want to be close to the Creator. Arjuna, you are a warrior, not in here, your place. Yes, Panembahan, but in here I pray to God. Since you know my name, may I know yours. It's not important for you, Arjuna. It's not important for you because you are the warrior not useful. Arjuna, don't you know that many people struggling because of injustice? Why do you go to this place and hide in here, Arjuna? Because you are unuseful, Arjuna. So I will kill you now. Thank you. at that time, Sang Panembahan will destroy Begawan Ciptoning as Arjuna. Sang Panembahan is ready with his supernatural power. Immediately, Begawan Ciptoning or Arjuna go to Panembahan. He bowed down and pray. It is because Arjuna pray, then disappear Sang Panembahan. He returned to his original form as Bathara Guru. It has been clearly proven that you are a true warrior. You can control yourself and be calm. So that you can pray. You really prefer to close to the Creator rather than indulge your desire. Arjuna, therefore, I give you a magical weapon in the form of an arrow called Kiai Pasopati. The tip of which is in the shape of a crescent moon. The crescent shape tip of Kiai Pasopati's arrow was made from Bathara Kala's tongue, which at the time was cut by his father or me, Bathara Guru. Kiai Pasopati only want to be owned by a warrior who is able to control himself, is not greedy, and prioritizes the safety and goodness of others rather than following his own desire. And this weapon will unite it within you, Arjuna, as long as this noble character fill your soul, but it will leave you if these qualities disappear from you. You cannot use this magical weapon at any time according to your wishes, but it will always be ready to help you when you fight without having any hatred against an enemy, no matter how strong. The last thing you must remember, Arjuna, is that the more you have a magical inheritance, the more you must be a blessing to others. It's because from everyone who has been given much, much will be demanded. And from the one who has been entrusted with much, much more will be asked. At this very moment, I anoint you as the man of the universe, as the messenger of all warriors to eradicate the iniquity. You need to know, Arjuna, that at this time, the iniquity exists in the form of the giant king from Himo, Himantoko, with the title Prabhu Niwata Kawaca, who is currently attacking Suraloya. Bumi gonjang ganjing, katon ler kincang ing alis risang mawe gandrung saparang katulukir moyak mayik sing tias bali wur This is all my message to you, Arjuna. Then Ulun will return to Suraloya. Raden Arjuna or Bergawan Ciptoni, he received the weapon namely Pasopati and we change the story. This is about the Himo Himantoko Kingdom. Thank you. this is a view at the Himo Himantoko or Manimantoko State Place. A giant country that is rich and prosperous, but very lawless. A very big giant is sitting on the royal throne. He was Prabhu Niwoto Kawoco, a giant king who was very powerful, but cunning, cruel, and very greedy. At that time, Prabhu Niwoto Kawoco was asking the Bathoros so that he could marry Bathari Suprabo, even though he already had a wife named Bathari Sanjivati. Prabhu Niwoto Kawoco was known to be very powerful and invisible. No weapon or supernatural power could injure him. This is because he has a supernatural power called Aji Gineng Mangreskerti, which is located on the roof of his mouth. It was by relying on his supernatural powers that King Niwoto Kawoco forced the universe to recognize him as the king of the Triloka, or king of the universe. Soyo Indriyakso Soro Maruto Pawono Pono Margono Samirono Lan Warayang Coba yuwisi an magulingan limo. Pucleng pucleng, iblis lanat podo cek-cekan. For too long time, Bathara have not kept their promise to give Batari Suprabha to be my wife. Hey, giant warriors, let us now attack Kayangan Suraloya. If the Bathara don't want to give Batari Suprabha, then we have to destroy everything there. Mawur mangawur-awur wurahan tengarane ngajure Om maguru kongso Kong maguru kongso tetek kaya butul Suara panjeriting turangga esti Regata sang ketitir Regata ingkang dwaja layu Sopoi Raden Arjuna Go Go If you'd want to go I will destroy you. Iblis lanat who are you? I am Arjuna. And who are you? I am Prabhu Niwata Kawaca. Arjuna, if I can remind you, go to there, don't stop me, I will destroy Kahyangan Suraloyo. Niwata Kawaca, if I can remind you, don't continue your bad intentions. Well, adalah. I will destroy you and make you my food, Arjuna. Unable tukup niwoto kawocos power. Raden Harjuno print immediately. By God will, he saw a white light emitting from the roof of Prabu Niwoto Kawaco Smut. So, Raden Harjuno immediately aim his arrow Kiai Pasopati, directed to the light. So King Niwoto Kawaco died instantly.